Hello everyone, welcome back to another video, and today I am playing Legend of the Bone Sword, but we're doing a similar thing I've done before. I'm going to be interviewing the owner of Legend of the Bone Sword, aka Krithum. Would you like to say hi?
I'm here.
Yes, you are here. So I'm just going to be asking you questions. I'm sure you already know that because I said that already. And you're just going to answer them, and don't worry if you're going to ramble too long. You can do that. Any answers are fine, whether they're long or short. So you ready for the first question?
Yep.
All right. What was your first thoughts going into making Legend of the Bone Sword?
Well, I guess originally, I hate to admit this, but originally I made this game when I was 12 and I made it to make Robux.
Yeah.
But of course that changed over time. I always wanted to make games since I was like 7 years old. I played Mario Kart and I wanted to make custom tracks because I saw it on YouTube.
Yeah.
And I was like, I want to make that.
That's really cool. Yeah, I heard you could give a more insightful answer because you can confirm that VN joined making the game after the true Bone Sword. Or was it the normal Bone Sword?
I think it was around after the Bone Lord was added.
Yeah.
That I brought him on board.
Mm-hmm. When he came on board, did you feel more confident about making the game and less stressed?
I was actually starting to work on the game less because at that point I've been working on the game for like a few months and that was my first game.
Yeah.
So I need to try something else to learn to improve.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, are you ready for the second question then?
Yep.
All right. Did you ever have plans for a stopping point in Legend of the Bone Sword development wise?
So this actually happened a couple times. Originally, I was going to stop the game at level 100, which is where the Bone Sword used to be. Now, you'll see the Bone Lord's son is level 100, but that was actually originally the Bone Lord. And if you go on YouTube and look up some old Bone Sword videos, you'll see that that is where the Bone Lord is.
Oh, really? I didn't know that was ever originally the Bone Lord. I think I joined when the event portal was made, so I would have never known that.
Yeah, that was a while ago, but after that was added, a bunch of people were like, no, more game, please.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, I'll do a little bit more. And then I added, let's see, is it this one? No. Okay, so it was this one.
Yeah.
This area right here.
Yeah.
This was the first area after the Bone Lord. And at that point, I haven't changed it yet. It was still the Bone Lord. But
yeah,
you'll see it's called Encore Boss. That's why. Because it's the
Encore.
Yeah,
yeah. Oh, that makes sense. I never thought about it like that. I actually barely know what the word Encore means, so it's good that you gave me insight on that.
I was 12 years old. There's a lot of stupid names.
Yeah. Speaking of the event room, like the one in the lobby 8K plus, when that was added, I forget. When that was added, was it the highest level area, or was it just a special event thing with a lower level cap than other areas?
This one's weird because Vinny worked on this while I was away from the game.
Oh, really?
So this, I don't really know too much about, to be honest, but
yeah,
I'm pretty sure at the time it might have been the highest. I'd have to look at that.
Yeah,
I don't know.
That makes sense. What do you think had the biggest impact on Legend of the Bone Sword?
Okay. I have a couple answers for that.
Yeah, that's fine.
In terms of recent events, probably, I don't really know what caused the player strike. What caused that?
I don't really know either. That's why I was curious
probably
about
it. The daily updates, because we committed to doing daily updates for a while, and then boom, the game blows up, and we're really happy. It was a very fun experience.
It sounds like it.
Originally, when the game was first starting out, the biggest thing that seemed to impact people coming back and bringing their friends in was the fact that you can just let people into other areas.
Yeah. And you could easily boost people. I remember that. Speaking of, Do you remember which update that got patched in?
It never did get patched because at the time I didn't know how to. I was such a new developer.
Yeah, but I thought the Titan areas and stuff, I thought you couldn't get their swords if you were too low level.
Yeah, so that was kind of our cutoff point for like, alright, if you're going to help your friends through the game, this is where it needs to stop.
Yeah, for sure.
But I'm pretty sure that's the number one reason people like this game, because they can just bring their friends in and carry them.
Do you feel like there's a sense of that that makes it feel more like a classic Roblox RPG? Do you think that contributes towards that?
Yeah, I think the lack of restriction is important.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Speaking of that, do you think that... Well, how do you feel having one of the most popular, like, classic Roblox RPGs?
It still doesn't feel like that.
It doesn't feel like that?
Like, I don't really do research on how big all these RPGs are.
Yeah.
But this just feels like another one of those RPGs that are just out there, because that's what it is.
I guess you'd be
right,
there's
nothing special.
I just feel
this
like...
This is the game.
I feel like most people talk about how this is the best, old-style Roblox RPG. Just because in the sense of, like, you know, all the different restrictions, most people remember how the old version looked, and that's probably what brings some people back. Do you think that's actually part of why the player base is a bit, like, frequent? Because some people came back from the old version?
Yeah, I've never redone the spawn area since, like, day one of Bonesword.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to lose the touch it has.
Oh, yeah,
it's just,
for sure.
It's like a comfort place you can come back to. It'll always be the same.
Yeah, that's what makes me happy about this place. I come back and I'm like, it's still the same. And, you know, I think if you were to change it, a lot of people would be upset. So probably is better that it stays this way. Do you enjoy making the game? And if so, what's your favorite thing about making it?
I definitely enjoy working on it. That's why nowadays I only work on it when I feel like it. Because I never want this to feel like it's work.
Yeah, yeah.
The main thing I like about it is how easy it is to update this game. Because a lot of games are really complicated nowadays.
Yeah,
and
for
it takes
sure.
all this effort to make all these models and things. But submissions are driving this game right now.
Oh,
and
yeah.
That means they don't have to do as much work. So it's really easy. It's quick and easy. People like it. I feel good.
All right, that was a pretty good answer. I actually felt pretty informed on that one. I'm really curious about this one. Are you happy with the current state of the community of the game?
I like most of the community.
Yeah.
But I think when it comes to the Discord and the admin team, they can get a little rowdy.
Probably, yeah. I just got here, so I don't know too much about that, but yeah.
General player base, though, I like them. They're supportive. A lot of them are actually screaming at me to give them admin all the time.
Yeah.
But in a weird way, that's kind of comforting.
Yeah, yeah. I had another follow-up question to that, but I forgot what it was. So how do you think content on YouTube affected the game? Or how do you feel about content on YouTube?
This is interesting, because the biggest confusion I have with that is that people who make Bonesword videos get more views than I've ever gotten on a Bonesword video.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Which is insane.
Well, most people who go on YouTube for this game are mainly looking up how to do something. Not necessarily much of, you know, the events that happen in it, just where to get something or when to get it, stuff like that.
Yeah, that makes sense. It also, it changed the way I think about YouTube videos on Roblox games, because I always thought all these games, like these meme games, get popular because some YouTuber played it and boosted the popularity. That's not true. That's not how it works.
It's not true, yeah.
And I found out the hard way when some big YouTubers played Bonesword and it had zero impact on the game.
Oh yeah, like, for sure.
The video's got hundreds of thousands of views, and Bonesword bumped up maybe a few players.
Yeah.
Didn't help at all.
Mm-hmm. Okay, this one is a really curious question. Why did you give up on the second Legend of the Bone Sword? If so, why?
So, Bone Sword 2, that was a really fun game to work on, but it fell victim to the classic game developer problem where you have to stop saying what if and start saying, all right, we have to have a cutoff. When is this game going to be done? What does the final product look like? You have to know that. Sure. If you keep saying, it would be cool to do this, you're never going to finish.
Yeah. So, with that being said, you said you need to know when to stop. Does that mean you have a plan for a stopping point in this game?
Again, I originally had a couple stopping points. The second one was originally going to be Mother of Chaos. That was going to be the last update.
I
can't keep myself from this game. People like it, and if I just let it die, I'm having a repeat of what happened before. This is like the perpetual RPG.
I can't let it die. I heard you and Vinny really, really, really love making this game. It sounds like a passion of yours almost.
Yeah, we work on it when we feel like we have some free time and think it'll be fun.
So that's why updates are less frequent, especially since you have other things to work on, especially Plush Wars. But whenever I heard when you get burnt out or when you feel bored at making the other games, you come back to this and just add something.
Yeah, if anyone here is watching and feels like, I want more updates, well, our updates are directly linked to how many submissions we get, so we haven't gotten any submissions in a while. So if you want more updates, maybe hopping in the Discord, give us some submissions.
Yeah, that's a good point. If anyone is watching this video and you can model in Roblox or make enemies, make swords, anything like that, go ahead and join the Discord server. I'll put it in the description. You can make submissions and then boom, there's more updates for everyone. We'll be sure to make sure you get attention for making it too.
Yeah, you get your name on a sign.
Yep, it's pretty special. It's pretty special. Before we go, are there any questions you want to answer that people ask very frequently that you may find annoying?
Okay. How to pronounce my name. You ready? Open your ears.
Oh, God.
It's...
You heard it here first.
Krytham.
Oh, my God,
like
guys.
Krytham with a C?
Oh, my
Krytham.
God.
Vini.
And
Phoenix's name.
Yeah.
It's Phoenix. Like Phoenix, but with a V. It's Phoenix.
I only just realized that recently. That's pretty good you clarified how to say your name, because my brother says Krytham. I don't know where he got that from, but apparently Krytham is your name now. No, but that was really fun interviewing you. Thank you for giving insight on all these answers. Thank you and Vinny for making this video, making time for it. And hopefully, with all these questions answered, you'll get some people off your back. Also, can I have Cetera? Thank you all for watching very, very much. And you want to say bye?
Bye.